So let's now deal with the representation of numbers. So if we write something like a equals 3.3, then this is stored as a double floating point. So double floating point. And for this reason, we can also write, for example, 3.3e16. That's also a double floating point and is 3.3 multiplied by 10 to 16. So what is special in MATLAB is that we also can create complex numbers. Yeah, so we can also write 3.3 plus and then creating a complex number, for example, like 2i semicolon. It looks a bit like a j here, but this is an I. So we have got 2i. Let's try this out. And b equals 3.3 plus 2i semicolon. So now we see we've got our real part here and our imaginary part here. J is also allowed for those who like to use rather J as an indicator for floating point. Now the question is, so how can we create other types of variables? So these variables are all floating point variables. So imagine we would like to create integer variables which we need later to test our filter functions. And so in order to create integer variables, we can do the following. So MATLAB has predefined functions like int16, for example. So if you write this here, we are creating an integer which is 16 bits long. And of course, there are also other functions like int8, int32, and then the same functions also exist as unsigned. And then this is uint 16, 8, or 32. So these are all creating integer variables. Let's just quickly have a look if this works. So if you write, for example, x equals int 16, 3.3, so what we expect that x is only 3. In order to find out that this actually is an integer, we could use a class command which gives us back that x is actually the class integer with a precision of 16 bits.